Hi, welcome back to the site. Today we're going to take another look at NotebookLM. NotebookLM has been around for quite a while now, and it is just simply the best tool you can use if you want to do research. Let's have a look. There's new features. Let's get into it. Okay, so to navigate to NotebookLM, go to notebooklm.google. Try NotebookLM, and you may have to log in. I use it a lot, so I log in straight away, but you may have to log in to NotebookLM. But once you're in, it's absolutely free and really cool. And basically on this first page, you get all of your previous notebooks that you've created. And when you want to create a new one, you just press create new. So in this area, you can add your resources and you can just drag files into this middle bit area. You can link to Google Drive, Google Docs, Google Slides. You can link a website. You can add in a website link, or you can put a YouTube video in there. Really cool. You know, I use YouTube a lot to learn stuff. Being able to link them, put them in a notebook, really, really fantastic. You can paste some text, put some copied text in. So there's loads of ways of getting your sources in there. And think about this as a sort of empty barrel, and you put all the information in there. Once that information's in there, you can do loads of really cool stuff with it. Now, there's a brand new feature with NotebookLM. It's only been around for a week or so, and it's this here on the right-hand side where it says Discover Resources. And what this does is allow you to tell it what you're interested in, and then it will go and find the resources that it needs to bring into NotebookLM. Let's give it a go. I put in here, I want to research the strengths and weaknesses of the new Chinese LLMs. You just submit that. You can actually say, I'm just feeling curious, and it'll go off and find things. But what it will do is go off and discover a whole series of resources. And here you can see we've got documents, PDFs, all sorts of things that it's gone and found. And you just go through and have a look. And if you're happy with them, you press import. You can knock them off if there's things that you don't particularly want. And it will just go and grab all of those documents and bang them into your document tray over here. Takes a few seconds. You can live with that. And there we go. Now, one hasn't loaded very well, hasn't loaded properly. So you can either delete it or you can try again with it. No, it's still not working. I'll delete that. I'll remove that source now. And so we've got a whole series of resources in there. Fantastic. You can add up to 50. You want a bit more? You want to ask some more? So I've said, find me discussions about the ethical challenges of Chinese LLMs. So it will go off. But this is just adding to the knowledge that I've put together. You can imagine how powerful this will be if you want to create a really interesting document that brings in multiple facets. So what I would suggest is if you're using this and you're wanting to look at a specific area in a number of different ways, then do a different discover on the different ways. And of course, you can add in your own documents, from academia, from newspaper articles, from the blogs, webs, etc. You can add all of that in. This just allows you to add a whole load of stuff in quickly, then it goes out and searches, saves an enormous amount of time. Okay, so you can add notes into it. You can have an audio overview. And this absolutely used to be NotebookLM's sort of party piece. It will create a little podcast about the documents that you put in. And then you've got this new feature here, mind map. This, very cool. You click on the mind map, it creates the new mind map. Then once it's created, you can open it. And there you go, Chinese large language models. And over here, it gives you all of the things that it's got documents on. So evaluation, risks and safeguards, development and research, and societal and ethical considerations. And then if you click along here, it will bump out to benchmarks, metrics, privacy protection. And then you can go out again, general privacy information, contextual privacy, privacy under attacks. Let's go and have a look at what it says on that. And it will go to the very document. It will identify the specific bit that it has learned about privacy under attacks. And there you go, and it gives you it. Such a powerful tool to do research. Really, really cool. So let's have a look at what else it can do. So you can definitely create the audio overview. You just click here. It takes a few seconds to load, but then you get this.
Ever stop to think how much of what we see online is being, nudged along by AI? It's kind of wild, right? This invisible layer shaping the information landscape. And today we are diving deep into a particularly fascinating corner of that, Chinese LLMs, large language models.
Right. It's huge. And you've brought together a really interesting...
We won't do a lot more of that. But we've now got this interactive mode. Let's have a look at what happens when you try and join the conversation that NotebookLM has created. So
there
press
was this
play.
Analysis looking at how certain talks are handled.
Okay, let's.
Could you talk about how you think that the Chinese LLMs have pushed on people like OpenAI and Google to increase the quality of their services?
That's a really interesting point.
It definitely adds another layer to the whole discussion.
I think the rapid advancements we're seeing out of China,
especially with models like DeepSeek being touted as rivals,
absolutely creates a competitive environment.
It challenges the existing players to innovate faster.
How cool is that? You can just jump in and ask a question and it'll respond to your question. Very cool. Not sure what the use case is, but it's still very, very cool. All right. So the other options you've got are a study guide. So you can, I think I've already done this to save you having to wait for it. So here we have the study guide. Here we go. So here's a study guide. It takes you through the overview of the LLMs and the development, safety and alignment of Chinese LLMs, evaluation and benchmarking. So if you're learning a subject, if you're doing some research and you're wanting to learn that subject in detail, using this will guide you through doing that learning. Really, really powerful. And I'll say it again, it's free. It doesn't cost a penny. This is really, really powerful stuff. We go back, next thing you've got is a briefing document, and it will give you a really detailed briefing document based on all of the documents, the sources that you've uploaded. Really useful, really powerful, and really quick. You've got frequently asked questions. So here's some frequently asked questions. How useful is that? Sources mention jailbreaking LLMs. What does this mean in the context of LLMs? And what are some of the techniques used to achieve it? And it gives you an answer. Very, very cool. And then you have this timeline feature. It generates from the 19 sources. You can remember, you can add up to 50 sources in NotebookLM. Really powerful way of doing it. Here we've got a timeline here. And there it goes. It gives you a timeline of the main events related to LLMs. How long, and a cast of characters, how long would it take you to pull that together if you were doing this research, if you're going through all of these documents and going through this research? And remember, it's these documents. So you can go back, check them. Are you happy with them? Do you think they're credible? Really, really powerful. Okay, that's NotebookLM. A really useful tool that you can use. It's absolutely free, powered by Google, who I must say are absolutely killing it at the moment with their new models, their Google Studio, the access that they're giving people to their latest bits of technology, all absolutely free. They're absolutely killing it. Gemini, I did a recent video on Gemini's deep research, and you know what? It beat ChatGPT. Have a look at it here if you want to have a look. So Google really lifted their game. I think 6 months ago, I felt that Google were a bit sort of meh. They were a bit grey. There was nothing very exciting. NotebookLM was probably the best thing they did. It's still one of the best things they've done, but they're doing much more now. So Google are absolutely one of the big players to watch. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Don't forget to drop me a like and subscribe and share the video with people if you think they'll be interested in it. And I will see you soon. I've been the professor. It's been my absolute pleasure to talk to you today, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye for now.